Open Education for a Better World, OE4BW. How to Read and Write Dagbani. An open educational resource. Developer is Musah Fuseini and the mentor is Jako, Olivier. Course outline. We shall be looking at the introduction, Dagbani language alphabets, Dagbani vowels, types of vowels, short vowels, long vowels, Dagbani consonants, types of consonants, single consonants, double consonants or digraphs, special Dagbani characters, capital and small letters, vowel consonant combination, vowel sequence, combining letter sounds to form Dagbani words, single letter words, two-letter words, three-letter words, four-letter words, breaking words into syllables, punctuation marks, reading sentences, reading passages, reading and comprehension, common mistakes in Dagbani writing, then assessment. Introduction. The purpose of this course is to guide beginners to be able to read and write in Dagbani fluently. Dagbani is a Mabia language spoken in Ghana. It is a compulsory subject in primary and junior high school in the Dagbon Kingdom. Dagbani is the most widely spoken language in northern Ghana, especially among tribes overseen by the king of Dagbon, Yana. It is closely related to and mutually intelligible with the Mampuli language spoken by the Mampuses in the northeast region of Ghana. Dagbani is also similar to other languages of the same subgroup spoken in northern Ghana, the Dagari and Wala languages spoken in the upper west region of Ghana, and the Farfar language spoken in the upper east region of Ghana. Spellings in the Dagbani language follow the sounds produced by letters used in the language. To be able to read and write in the Dagbani language, one needs to acquaint themselves with the sounds of letters of the Dagbani language. This probably makes reading and writing in Dagbani quite easy. Reading and writing in Dagbani is not as complex as it is in some other languages, such as the English language, where the reading of some words are phonic, that is, the sound of each letter in a word counts, whilst others are not. For instance, in the English language, words such as cut, bent, ring, tank, net, in, etc. are phonic, whereas words such as through, sight, science, country, court, photo, etc. are not. Thus, in the English language, a letter may sound differently depending on where it is used. This is not the case in reading and writing in the Dagbani language. You just need to grasp the sound each letter makes and you are good to go. This self-paced course takes about 10 hours to complete, and learners are expected to be able to read and write fluently after committing themselves to going through all the sections of the course. Dagbani language alphabets. Dagbani Bachi Koba. The focus of this section is to guide learners, especially beginners, to be able to identify the letters in the Dagbani language, the sound each letter makes, and how to blend these sounds to form words. Letters of the Dagbani language are grouped into two: vowels, that is vowel number, and consonants, consonant number. Vowels, vowel number. Dagbani vowels, just like vowels of the English language, are the sounds the production of which there is no obstruction in the passage of air. They are also called vowel number in Dagbani. Types of vowels. There are two types of vowels: short vowels, vowel jihi, and long vowels, that is vowel wala. Note, the brackets are used to enclose letter sounds. Thus, This differentiates inscription of sounds of letters from writing the letters themselves. Example, the sound of the letter E is written as this. Short vowels, vowel J. Dagbani uses 7 short vowel sounds in writing. The following are the short vowels. A, E, E, I, O, O, U. Again, A, E, E, I, O, O, U. These vowels are used in the following examples. A, as in la, that is laugh. E, as in ye, that is wear. E, yellum, salt. E, d, that is eat. U, do, climb. O, as in go, that is travel. Short vowels, vowel J. Dagbani uses 7 short vowel sounds in writing. The following are the short vowel sounds. A, E, E, I, O, O, U. Again, we have A, E, E, I, O, O, U. These vowels are used in the following word examples. A, as in la, that is laugh. E, as in ye, that is wear. E, as in yellum, that is salt. E, D, that is eat. U, do, that is climb. O, go, that is travel. O, guam, that is sleep. Long vowels, vowel wala. The following are the long vowels in the Dagbani language. They are described as long because the two vowels combine to give one sound. They are 5 in number. We have A, E, I, O, U. Again, A, E, I, O, U. Note, there are no long vowels for E and O in Dagbani. These sounds are not used in native Dagbani words. The long vowels are used in the following examples. A, as in ba, that is dog. E, as in lemu, that is orange. E, as in liga, that is shirt. U, as in do, that is room. O, as in no, that is foul. Note, one needs to be very mindful of where to use either a short or a long vowel. They are not interchangeable at all. For example, ba means father, whilst ba means dog. So you can imagine the blunder one would be causing if they interchange a for a or vice versa. Dagbani consonant. Consonant nama. Consonants can be described as speech sounds that are not vowels. They are sounds, the production of which there is some obstruction in the passage of air. Dagbani consonants are 7 in number and are grouped into 2 types of consonants. The 2 types of consonants are single consonants, that is consonant gansi, and double consonants, that is digraphs, consonant jaba in Dagbani. single consonants. Consonant gansi, they are b, d, f, g, h, h, j, k, l, m, n, ng, p, r, s, t, v, w, y, z, and j. Again, they are b, d, f, g, h, h, j, k, l, m, n, ng, p, r, s, t, v, w, y, z, and j. The letters C, Q, and X are not included in the Dagbani alphabet. They are not used in spelling Dagbani words. Note, in Dagbani, the letter C does not exist as a single letter. It however combines with H as a double consonant J. Single consonants can be used in the following examples. Emphasis here is on the single letter consonant. B, as in ba, that is father or right. D, as in dua, that is sick, stick. F, as in fo, that is quiet. G, as in galli, that is egg. H, as in pa, that is woman. Note, the H sound does not begin a word in Dagbani. H, as in hale, that is even. J, as in janga, that is monkey. K, as in kwam, that is water. L, as in liam, that is umbrella. M, as in mana, that is okru. N, as in nahu, that is cattle. Ng, as in ngamli, that is hippopotamus. P, as in puli, that is stomach. R, as in kruga, that is bowl. Note, there is no native Dagbani word beginning with the sound R. S, as in sala, that is charcoal. T, as in tia, that is tray. V, as in vari, that is leaves. W, as in wahu or wahu, that is horse or snake. Y, as in yum, that is night. Z, as in zabri, that is hair. And j, as in jim, that is blood. Among the single consonants used in Dagbani, the ones that may pose difficulty in pronouncing to non-natives are h, ng, and j sounds. This is more especially in the case of h, whose sound hardly exists in English. Although the consonants ng and j do not exist as single consonants in English, their sounds are used in English. For instance, ng is found in words such as sing, long, wrong, came, etc. Also, j is found in words like pleasure, measure, pressure, etc. Double consonants, that is consonant jeba. A double consonant is made up of a pair of different consonants that make one sound. They are also called digraphs. They include chi, bo, bo, nye, mo, and sh. Again, che gbo po nyi mo and sh. Among these consonants, English readers are familiar with ch and sh, as in church and shoe respectively. Digraphs are used in the following Dagbani words. Gbo, as in gbali, that is leg. Gbo, as in pam, that is oil. Mo, as in money, that is calabash. Chi, as in chichi, that is bicycle. Sh, as in shia, that is bee. Nye, as in nyuli, that is yam. Note, both the single and double consonants add up to the total of 27 consonants in Dagbani. Special Dagbani characters. Among the vowels and consonants mentioned above, there are some alphabets that are not among English alphabets, but are among the Dagbani alphabets. These alphabets are E, O, H, N, and J. Again, E, O, H, N, and J. These characters are used in the following English word examples. E, as in bell. O, as in not. H, as in pa. Note, the H sound does not exist in English language. N, as in sing, and J, as in pressure. Note, the E and O are vowels, whilst H, N, and J are consonants. Capital and small letters. The way the capital and small letters are written in the English language is not different from how they are written in the Dagbani language. However, special attention needs to be paid to how the capital and small letters of the Dagbani special characters are written. These are the special characters. Note, again, it is worthy of notice that the letters C, Q, and X are not among the Dagbani alphabets as single letters. Vowel consonant combination. Now take a look at the sounds made by combining vowels and consonants. Note, focus here is on sound and not meaning. B, ba, be, be, bi, bo, bo, bu, da, da, de, de, di, do, do, du, fa, fa, fe, fe, fi, fo, fo, fu, g, ga, ge, ge, gi, go, go, gu, ha, ha, he, 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 ho, ho, hu, j, ja, ji, je, ji, Jo, Jo, Ju, Ke, Ka, Ki, Ke, Ki, Ku, Ko, Ku, Le, La, Li, Le, Li, Lu, Lo, Lu, Ma, Mi, Me, Mi, Mu, Mo, Mu, Na, Na, Ni, Ne, Ni, No, No, Nu, Ng, Nga, Ngi, Nghe, Nghi, Ngu, Ngo, Ngu, P, Pa, Pi, Pe, Pi, Pu, Po, Pu, R, Ra, Ri, Re, Ri, Ru, Ro, Ru, S, Sa, Si, Se, Si, Su, So, Su, T, Ta, Ti, Te, Ti, Tu, To, Tu, V, Va, Vi, Ve, Vi, Vu, Vo, Vu, then the sound wo, wa, we, 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 wo, 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 ye, ya, ye, 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 yo, yo, you, z, za, ze, ze, zi, zu, zo, zu, je, ja, je, je, ji, jo, jo, ju. Vowel sequence, that is vowel gansidom pataba. The Dagbani orthography spells out the accepted vowel sequence in writing Dagbani. They are Ua, Ia, Io, and Oi. Here are some word examples. For Ua, we have Bua, Pua, Sua, Nanzua, etc. For Ia, we have Tia, Bia, Pia, etc. For Oi, we have Poi, Ayo Poi, among others. For Io, we have Pio, among others. Vowel sequences like these hardly exist in Dagbani, even though they do exist in the English language. Combining letter sounds to form Dagbani words. The letter sounds, both vowels and consonants, combine to form most Dagbani words. There, however, are some few words which are formed by one consonant or vowel. Thus, Dagbani words could be made up of one, two, or more letters. Single letter words. N or M, that is I or me or my, that is the first person singular pronoun. They are used in the following examples. 1. Nyuli Musa Machangda Mbukumbala Mpada Chichi Naba Biarmi Nchichema Sahami. Note, M is used for I or me or my, where the next word begins with a bilabial sound, B, M or P. N is used where the next word begins with any other letter or sound. This is from the approved Dagbani orthography. Example 2. A. That is you, second person singular pronoun. It is used in these examples. A. Badim Sa'amma. Abadim Sa'amma. Babunini Bu'apam. Bamunini Bu'apam. Example 3. O. That is him or her or she or he. That is the third person singular pronoun. It is used in these examples. O kana shukuru zungo. O kana shukuru zungo. Tim o mahama ashele. Tim o mahama ashele. Note, do not join the single letter words with other words when writing. For example, do not write Okana, one word, Okana Shukuru Zumo, or Agba, that's one word, Agba Dim Sama. It is supposed to be written as Okana Shukuru Zumo and Agba Dim Sama, respectively. Two letter words. Here are some examples. Ba, that is father or right. Be, that is in. Bo, that is day. Bu, that is beat. Bu, that is fine. Da, that is buy. Di, that is eat. Do, that is lay. Do, that is climb. Fa, that is snatch. Fo, that is quiet. Go, that is travel. Gu, that is protect. Ja, that is crash. J, that is refuse. Ka, have not. Ku, kill. La, laugh. Lo, tie. Le, feel. Ma, mother. Mo, that is struggle. Me, that is build. Ni, awake. Ngo. This. Pa. Not. Pe. That is arrange. Pu. That is group. Sa. That is plant. Su. Bathe. So. Where. Or someone. To. Bitter. Or pound. Ti. That is we. Or vomit. Va. That is collect. Or wrestle. Vo. That is pool. V. Shy. Wa. Dance. Ya. Where. You. Love. Za. That is guinea corn. Zo. Run. And zoo. That is steal. Three letter words. Here are some few examples. Bam, that is odor. Dam, that is alcohol. Guam, that is sleep. Kam, that is everything. Liam, that is umbrella. Mam, that is lover. Nam, that is leadership. Pang, that is buru. Sam, that is marsh. Tam, forget. Yum, sore or wound. Four letter words. Here are some few examples. We have bana, that is them. Dira, eating. Fale, inheritance. Gala, that is X. Jara, fools. Kule, ho. Lunga, drum. Mana, okru. Noa, scorpion. Paa, woman or wife. Sala, that is charcoal. Twale, mortar. Vari, that is leaves. Wala, fruits. Yole, nothing. And zama, that is crowd. Note, Dagbani words could be in as many letters as possible. Also, there is no native Dagbani word that starts with the sound r. There are, however, some borrowed words or names that begin with r sound. When pronouncing such words or names, the r is replaced with l sound. For example, rubaba and rabi are pronounced as lubaba and labi respectively. Also, rubber is pronounced as loba. Breaking words into syllables. A syllable is a part of a word that contains a single vowel sound that is pronounced as a unit. For example, there are two syllables in the word water and three in the word important. Reading Dagbani is usually easier when syllables in words are identified and clearly pronounced accordingly. Here are some word examples. 1. Ma has one syllable, that is ma. 2. Da has one syllable, that is da. 3. Lunga has two syllables, that is lu and nga. Gbali has two syllables, gba and li. Gbali. Nyungwali has three syllables, that is nyin, go and li. Nyungwali. Ashili has three syllables, that is a, she, li, ashili. Bachinama has four syllables, they are ba, chi, ni, ma. Bachinama. Bwasapim has four syllables, they are bo, o, sa, pim. Bao sa pim. Tolotolo also has four syllables, they are to, lo, to, lo, that is tolotolo. Sapashinama has got five syllables, they are sa, pa, shin, ni, ma. Sa, pa, shin, ni, ma. Five syllables. 11. Bachin nang dali has got five syllables, and they are ba, chi, nang, de, li. That is ba, chi, nang, de, li. Five syllables. Yele tu'ata'a malisi has got eight syllables. They are yel, to, ri, ta, ri, ma, li, si. That is yel tu'ata'a malisi. Punctuation marks. That is sabbu bibahara. Just as it is in reading and writing in other languages, such as English, reading and writing texts in Dagbani requires the correct usage of punctuation marks. The usage of the full stop, the comma, the question mark, the exclamation mark, and the quotation marks in English are not so different from how they are used in Dagbani. However, special attention needs to be paid to how the hyphen and the apostrophe or deletion sign are used in Dagbani. 1. Full stop or zanbibia in Dagbani. They are usually placed at the end of a sentence. Example: Karambadala luru palli. Karambadala luru palli, full stop. 2. Comma, that is vombia in Dagbani. It is usually placed in between a list of items. Example: Nde yuru bendiri shanganye, saam, tubani, gwara, ninyongbeka. Again, in the Yurubundir Shanganye, Sam, comma, Tubani, comma, Bora, comma, Ninyombika. 3. Question mark. That is Bahubia. It is placed at the end of a question. Example. Yakale chana? Question mark. 4. Exclamation mark. That is yechini bia. It is usually used after interjections or sentences that indicate strong feelings or show emphasis. Here are some few examples. Example 1. Oi, sama biani. Oi, sama biani. Example 2. Kui, oyankuma. Kui, oyankuma. 5. Hyphen. Aside from being used as it is used in English, the hyphen is also used in between an auxiliary verb and a main verb. Here are some few examples. 1. Zamabukuma mpa table zo. Pa, that is to place, is the main verb here, and acts as an auxiliary or helping verb. Example 2. Pangme amanga mmi yili. Pangme amanga mmi yili. Me, that is to build, is the main verb. Acts as an auxiliary or helping verb here. Example 3. Nangme yoma mbwal bima. Bole, that is call, is the main verb. Acts as an auxiliary or helping verb. Example 4. Ligalan doyala. Doya, that is lay, is the main verb and acts as an auxiliary or helping verb here. Example 5. Timunon kana. Kana, that is came, is the main verb here. Acts as an auxiliary or helping verb here. Example 6. Otola numa in ye. Ye, that is fly, is the main verb here. Acts as an auxiliary or helping verb. Abudala sam ndi. D, that is eat, is the main verb. Acts as an auxiliary verb here. The last example is Kokalana ngumdi jababu kumsi. Wumdi, that is listen, is the main verb. Acts as an auxiliary or helping verb. Note, special attention needs to be paid to the usage of the and in these instances. As already explained earlier in section 8.1, is used where the following word begins with a bilabial like b, m, or p.
6. Apostrophe or deletion sign, that is mabahbia in Dagbani. This punctuation mark comes at the end of the shortened form of a word to indicate that a letter or letters of the root word has been omitted or deleted. This usually applies to nouns followed by its qualifier adjective. It is known as apostrophe in English, and its usage in Dagbani is completely different from how it is used in English. Here are some few examples. Bua plus kurli becomes bukurli. The A in Bua has been deleted. Example 2. Zo plus Bla becomes Zo Bla. U in Zo has been deleted. 3. No plus Bla becomes Nobla. The O in no has been omitted. Tim plus Tuao becomes Tituao. The M in Tim has been omitted. Bendirugu plus Shelley becomes Bendir Shelley. The Igu in Bendirugu has been omitted. And Guli plus Pielli becomes Gupielli. The Li in Guli has been omitted. Note, one or more letters of the parent word could be omitted.
Reading sentences. Now let us read some sentences. 1. Nyule Musa. Nyule Musa. 2. Naporo Beju. Naporo Beju. 3. Machangda. Machangda. 4. Karambadala Luru Palle. Karambadala Luru Palle. 5. Obukana Shukuru Zungo. Obukana Shukuru Zungo. 6. Sohalaka Tisakuna. Sohalaka Tisakuna. 7. Azundo Yala Liga G. Azundo Yala Liga G. 8. Abuni ozo unyara. Abuni ozo unyara. 9. Dana pola pa palu. Dana pola pa palu. 10. Busaya kwela luri nchang ankara. Busaya kwela luri nchang ankara.
Reading passages. Let's read the following passage. Nama idan nayi mbongo. Nayi malangara. Ongarang mbongo. Nayi malla ongarang ma ndure nirba. Osong de nirba pam. Ngarang ndure la kwamni. Nayi mingarang ndobo pam. Nayi ngarang bara kadu ngaran duru biela ngaran nyanga kabambe dinimi be dituni ngaran duvutu kamel barna dama ngaran ibe komni lanemi dizoka dagban pambiyera ne banke ngaran bellar kimba. This is an extract from the book Karmi Dagbani Buku 1 by Literacy and Development Through Partnership, LDP, a Tamil-based local NGO. Let me read the extract again. Nama idan na yimbongo. Na yimalla ngarang. Ongarang mbongo. Na yimalla ongarang ma. Ndure nirba. Osong de nirbo pam. Ngarang duhur la komni. Nae mi karang ngarang duhur pam. Nae ngarang bara kaju. Ngarang duhur biala ngarang nyanga. Kabambe dini mi bi dituni. Ngarang duhur tu kamal barna. Dama ngarang ibe komni lanemi. Di zuɣu ka Dagban kpamba yɛra ni ban kpe ŋarim bi lari kpiimba.
Reading comprehension. Read the following passage and answer the questions that follow. Zumo nyela katangda. Katangda bela tolang. Da bi nyela ban yir Dagban boba ni yaa nkanna nti dir katangda. Hal shab yir la zawanu nkanna nti dir dama. Kohamma ni damma balibu zuu ya katangda ni pam. Nga shanga nye karwana. Shinkafa, chi, za, sima, yayar, dasam, kuku, bambi, guli, jagbana, pakahali, chi, zuna, gora, yona, nyombika, nangampai. Mba azindu gwa jiri katangda. Obun naari nga dewu. Wanyela nansar kwa. Oni chang katangda ni zungo. Oma la tabbula yi. Nuzan chang nti kwae. Oye chang nti kwae nga naay. Oyendala omamang ya yardalia ni jinjam. Kada yona manu gwara mali bihi yinga. Let me read the passage again. Zungo nyela katangda. Katangda biela tolang. Da bihi nyela ban yir Dagban boba ni ya. Nkana ntijir katangda. Hali shab yir la zawanu nkana ntijir dama. Kwa ni damma balibu zuu ya katangda ni pam. Nga shanga nye karwana, shinkafa, chi, za, sima, yayere, dasam, kuku, bambihi, guli, jagbana, pakahali, pihi, zuna, gora, yona, nyombika na ngampai. Mba azundu gwa jiri katangda. Obu naara ngajibu. Unyala na ansar kuha. Oni chang katangda ni zungo. Umalata bila yi. Nuzan chang ntukwai. Oye chang tukwai nganai. Oyendala omama ya yardalia. Jinjam, kada yonamon gwara, malibihi yinga. Now let's look at the questions. Question 1. Zungo nyela tengkanda. Question 2. Yakada abihi yirna, ntijir dama. Kwa hama, ndama dene. Mbi damani. Mungban yen chang katangda. Buko yen chang. Buko yen kwae damani. Buka oyen da. Ntuma. Kabuka oyen da. Malbehiyama.
Now, these are the answers. I trust your answers are close to these. 1. Katangda. 2. Dagban boba ni ya ni zabanu. 3. Karwana. Shinkafa. Chi. Za, sima, yayari, dasam, kuku,
Gbambe, Guli, Jagbana, Pakahali, Ti, Zuna, Gwara, Yona, Nyombika, Ngampai. 4. Mbazindu. 5. Tabulayi. 6. Yayar Dalia Mini Jinjam. 7. Yuana Mini Gwara.
Common mistakes in Dagbani writing. Let's be mindful of the following common mistakes in writing Dagbani and avoid them. 1. Combining separate words. It is common to see people combine two or more words as if they are one word. This can change the intended meaning or form non-existent words. This is mostly the case where one-letter words are involved. Let's look at these examples. 1. Amakuna. Ama, written like one word, is wrong. The correct one is Amakuna. Example 2. Utama lore. Utama, written like one word, is wrong. The correct way is Utama lore. Example 3. Onkana zongo. Unwritten as one word, is wrong. The correct way is Onikana zongo.
Common mistake 2. Separating single words. Other times too, people separate the syllables in the word, making them look like multiple words. Here are some few examples. Example 1. Zungo. As in today, Zungo written like two words is wrong. The correct way is Zungo one word. Example 2. Tuma. And the intended meaning here is work. The correct way is Tuma one word. Example 3. Nangban Yini. Separated as Nangban and Yini to look like two words is wrong. The correct one is Nangban Yini as one word. Example 4. Karamba. And the intended meaning is teacher. It's wrong. The correct way is Karamba one word. Example 5. Chama. As in go. Chama written like two words. Cha and ma is wrong. The correct way is chama as one word.
Common mistake 3. Use of long vowels instead of short vowels and vice versa. Here are some examples. Amakuna. This is wrong because the intended word here is ma, as in mother, not ma. So the correct one is amakuna. Example 2. Do ma kulia. This is wrong because the intended word here is do, as in man. So the correct one is do ma kulia. Example 3. Mbaa yuli abukari. This is wrong because the intended word here is ba as in father and not ba as in dog. So the correct one is mba yuli abukari. Example 4. Tikyam da. This is wrong because the intended word here is da as in market and not da as in buy. So the correct one is tikyam da.
Common mistake 4. Wrong usage of deletion sign. Here are some examples. Example 1. Tum tum dubuma kana. This is wrong because tum tum duba is one word. So the deletion sign should not come between tum and tum duba. So the correct way is tum tum duba one word. Tum tum duba ma kana. Example 2. Yung la ka abu sakuna. This is wrong because yung is a full word and no part of it has been omitted. Therefore, the deletion sign should not come after yung. The correct one is yung la without the deletion sign after yung. Yung la ka abu sakana. Example 3. Sokam kulimi oyinga. This is wrong because sokam is one word. So the deletion sign should not come between so and kam. The correct one is sokam one word without a deletion sign. Sokam kulimi oyinga. Common mistake 5. Wrong usage of the hyphen. Here are some examples. 1. Nsa chang la da is wrong. This is because n is not a noun and sa is not a qualifier. So the hyphen should not come between n and sa. It should rather be nsa without the hyphen. Nsa chang la da. Example 2. Nyen da la buku. N is a pronoun. Yen is not a qualifier. So the hyphen should not come between N and yen. The correct one is nyen without the hyphen. Nyen da la buku. 3. Mukulayanga. This is wrong because kula is one word. The hyphen should not become kul and la. The correct one is mukulayanga kula without the hyphen. Assessment. Now let's look at the following assessment. Assessment 1. Say the following sounds. Assessment 2. Identify the vowels from the following and write them down. Assessment 3. Identify the consonants from the following sounds and write them down. Assessment 4. Try to pronounce the following syllables on your own. Assessment 5. Try to pronounce the following words on your own. Assessment 6. Translate these words into Dagbani and write them down. 1. Laugh. 2. Dog. 3. Chair. 4. Honey. 5. Chest. 6. Profit. 7. Head. 8. Health. 9. Grandmother. And 10. Ignorance. Assessment 7. Read the following sentences. Assessment 8. Try to read the following passage and answer the questions that follow.